Welcome back. This is part 5 of my lecture series on profitability, alternative investments and replacements. And in this particular lecture, I will be discussing the fourth method that is used for profitability evaluation. The method is capitalized cost method. Let us understand the method. So this particular method, capitalized cost method, it is used for comparing investment alternatives within a single project. Instead of comparing multiple projects, in this particular method, options, investment options that may be available within a single project, they are compared. For example, in a chemical plant, if you want to have a reactor in the plant, then option available with you, for example, you could have a stainless steel reactor or you could have a mild steel reactor. So you have to decide on whether to invest money in getting stainless steel reactor or invest money in getting the mild steel reactor. So, in this particular case, if you want to compare the two options, you can use the method of capitalized cost. Okay. So, what is done in this case? The concept of capitalized cost, which is used for in case of a piece of equipment, this concept is extended to annual operating costs. The concept of capitalized cost used for a piece of equipment, it is extended to the annual expenses, annual operating expenses. And when you are doing so, when you are extending the concept of capitalized cost to annual expenses, the service life will be 1 year, because each annual expense will be valid for 1 year. So that is why the service life will be considered as 1 year. Okay. We already know how capitalized cost for a particular piece of equipment is calculated. We know that it is given as K is equal to CV plus CV minus CS divided by 1 plus I raised to N minus 1. And the terms involved in this equation, K is the capitalized cost, CV is the original cost of the equipment, CS is the salvage value or the scrap value of the equipment, N is the service life of the equipment in years, and I is the fractional rate of interest. So CV is the original cost of the equipment, the cost at which the equipment was originally purchased, original cost of the equipment. CH is the salvage value, or it could be a scrap value if you are not able to sell it as a second-hand equipment to someone else. You always have to sell it as a scrap, and the money obtained by selling it as a scrap will be the scrap value of that equipment. Okay. So capitalized cost for a piece of equipment is K is equal to CV plus CV minus CS divided by 1 plus I raised to N minus 1. Okay. So in short, capitalized cost is that cost which will be required for perpetual replacement of a particular equipment. Okay. So in the equation, CV minus CS, the original cost of the equipment minus salvage or scrap value, will be the replacement cost of the equipment. That is, if you have to replace the equipment, you need that much amount, CV minus CS. That is why it is called as replacement cost. Okay. So let us simplify, let us do some modifications with this equation. So you have K is equal to CV plus CV minus CS divided by 1 plus I raised to N minus 1. So I will simplify it in this way. So this will be CV into 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 plus CV minus CS divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1, which can further be simplified as 1 plus I raised to n into CV minus CV plus CV minus CS divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1. Again, you can go to the next step in this way, that is k is equal to 1 plus I raised to n into CV minus CS divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1. Okay, this can further be written in this way, k is equal to 1 plus I raised to n into CV minus 1 plus I raised to n into CS plus 1 plus I raised to n into CS minus CS. So what I have done in this step, I have added 1 plus I raised to n into CS and at the same time subtracted 1 plus I raised to n into CS. So then you can take 1 plus I raised to n common out of the two terms. So it will be 1 plus I raised to n into CV minus CS plus in the remaining terms you can take CS common. So it will be 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 into CS. The whole thing divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1. Okay. So that will be, after separating the denominator, you will get a simplified equation, which is k is equal to 1 plus I raised to n divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 into CR. As I talked about it earlier, CR is the replacement cost. So 1 plus I raised to n divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 into CR plus CS. CR is nothing but CV minus CS, and it is the replacement cost. So you have this equation. In this equation, we are getting this term 1 plus I raised to n divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1. This particular term, it is called as a capitalized cost factor. And this capitalized cost factor, we will be using and applying it to the sum of present values of annual operating cost, annual expenses. So you may have annual expenses for each of the year in the service life of the project. You find out the present values of these annual incomes, take their summation and apply the capitalized cost factor to get the capitalized cost for the operating expenses or operating cost. You will learn how it is done. So this factor is then applied to the sum of present values of annual operating costs. As we stated earlier, the annual operating cost is considered as a piece of equipment which is having a service life of 1 year. We have talked about it earlier in this particular method. Annual operating cost or annual operating expenses or annual expenses, they are considered as a piece of equipment having a service life of 1 year. Okay. Now, let us get the equation for calculating capitalized cost for operating expenses. So for that we will be using these notations. Let us call CO1, CO2, CO3 and finally CON as annual operating costs for the year 1, 2, 3 and finally N, the last year in the service life of the project. Now with this operating cost, the sum of the present values will be obtained in this way. So it will be CO1 divided by 1 plus I raised to 1 CO1 operating cost for first year divided by 1 plus I raised to n plus CO2 operating cost for second year divided by 1 plus I raised to 2 plus CO3 operating cost for third year divided by 1 plus I raised to 3 plus dash 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 plus for the final year. So for the nth year it will be CON divided by 1 plus I raised to n. Okay. Now, as we stated earlier, we have to apply the capitalized cost factor to this summation. So you get this equation after doing that. When the capitalized cost factor is applied to the above sum, the capitalized cost for operating cost is obtained. So, or the other way you can say that, you'll be obtaining capitalized operating cost. So capitalized operating cost, KO, will be given as 1 plus I raised to n divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1, the capitalized cost factor, and it is now applied to the sum of present values of the annual operating expenses or annual operating costs. So it will be 1 plus I raised to n divided by 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 into CO1 divided by 1 plus I raised to 1 plus CO2 in divided by 1 plus I raised to 2 plus CO3 divided by 1 plus I raised to 3 plus dash 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 plus finally CON divided by 1 plus I raised to n. So this will be capitalized operating cost. Once you get the capitalized operating cost, or before that you have to understand that the operating cost may be constant for each of the year in the service life. So if it is so, if the operating cost is same for all the years in the service life, then you can get a simplified equation for the capitalized operating cost, KO. And the equation is KO is equal to CO divided by I, where CO is the constant annual operating cost, I is the fractional rate of interest, and this equation is obtained from the equation that was shown in the previous slide, and you can easily get this equation. So this simplified equation has to be used if the operating cost is constant throughout the service life of the equipment. Okay. And finally, when you are getting the capitalized operating cost, you have got operating cost for the piece of equipment. Finally, with this, the total capitalized cost will be the addition of three terms. Which are these three terms? First is the capitalized cost for the piece of the equipment, plus capitalized operating cost, and finally plus the working capital investment. This three will give the total capitalized cost for a particular piece of equipment. Okay. And when you have, as we stated earlier, this method is used for selecting the best option. So when you are selecting best option, what you are going to do, you are going to select that option which has the least total capitalized cost. So if multiple options are available for comparison, then the option with least KT is to be selected. Okay. So this is how you can calculate total capitalized cost. The total capitalized cost is addition of three terms. First is capitalized cost for the piece of equipment. Then there is capitalized operating cost. And finally, you have the working capital investment. Okay. So to understand the method, we are going to discuss one numerical where you will learn how to find out total capitalized cost for a particular option, how to compare total capitalized cost for all the options, and then based on the values of the total capital cost, how to select the best option. Okay. So the numerical goes like this. Given the following data, which investment, if any, should be made by profitability analysis using capitalized cost method? The minimum acceptable rate of return is 15%. There are three investment options given. For each of the option, fixed capital investment is given, working capital investment is given, salvage value is given, service life in number of years is given, and finally annual expenses are given. So in this particular case, we will be finding out the total capitalized cost for each of the option, and we are going to recommend that option which will be having the least capitalized cost. So let us solve this. First, let us write down the given things. What are given? Three different investment options are given to us. For each investment option, the fixed capital investment, that is FCI, the working capital investment, that is WCI, the salvage value, that is CS, the service life, that is N, and annual expenses, CO, they are given. And based on this information, we are supposed to find out the best option. Again, you'll come to know that the annual expenses for each year in the service life, in this case, they are constant. For example, for investment number one, the annual expense is 44,000, and it will be constant for all the years. It will be constant for all the 5 years in the service life of that option. So we'll have to use the simplified equation for calculating KO, the capitalized operating cost. So we will be using that. Okay. Then they have also stated that the minimum acceptable rate of return is 15%, which means that I is 0.15. ठीक है, so let us go. The approach will be calculate total capitalized cost for each investment option and then recommend the option with least capitalized cost. ठीक है, let us go for investment number one. For investment number one, the total capitalized cost will be given as KT1 is equal to K1 plus K01 plus WCI1. Now our job is to find each of this term in order to get KT1, each of the three terms K1, K01 plus WC1 to get KT1. So first let us get K1. K1 will be given as we know the formula. It will be 1 plus I raised to N1 divided by 1 plus I raised to N1 minus 1 into CR1, the replacement cost for first option, plus CS1, the salvage value for first option. So it will be K1 is equal to 1 plus I raised to N1 divided by 1 plus I raised to N1 minus 1. CR1 will be given as fixed capital investment for first option minus salvage value for first option. So it will be FCI1 minus CS1 plus CS1. So if you put all the given values, you will get K1 as 1,88,989.33. Okay, K1. Then for we have to get K01 or KO1, whatever you may call it, K01 or KO1. Since the annual expenses are constant throughout the service life, K01 will be calculated in the following way. K01 will be equal to C01 divided by I. C01, that is annual expenses for option 1, they are given as 44,000. So K01 will be equal to 44,000 divided by 0.15, which comes out to be 2,93,333.33 K01 for this option. Then finally, once you have got K1 and K01, now you can calculate KT1, the total capitalized cost for this option. It will be KT1 is equal to K1 plus K01 plus WCI1. Therefore, it will be KT1 is equal to 1,88,989.33 plus 2,93,333.33 plus 10,000. So finally, this will be the total capitalized cost for first option will be 4,92,322.66. Okay, now let us do similar calculations for the second option. For second investment option, the total capitalized cost will be given as KT2 is equal to K2 plus KO2 plus WCI2. So first get K2. K2 will be given as 1 plus I raised to N2 divided by 1 plus I raised to N2 minus 1 into CR2 plus CS2. CR2 is replacement cost for the second investment option. CS2 is the salvage value for the second investment option. Put the given value. So it will be K2 is equal to 1 plus I raised to N2 divided by 1 plus I raised to N2 minus 1 into FCI2 minus CS2 plus CS2. So put the values, after putting all the values, we will get K2 as 2,63,372.38. Okay, next you have to calculate KO2 for this option. Again, the operating cost is constant throughout the service life, so it will be calculated as KO2 is equal to CO2 divided by I. CO2 is the operating cost for second option, which is given as 28,000. So KO2 will be equal to 28,000 divided by 0.15. So KO2 will be coming out as 1,86,666.67. So having got this, finally you can calculate the total capitalized cost for the second option, which will be obtained by adding K2, KO2 and WC2. So we'll get the total capitalized cost for the second option as 4,60,039.05. then let us do the calculations for investment option number 3. The total capitalized cost will be calculated as K3 plus KO3 plus WCI3. K3 will be given as 1 plus I raised to N3 divided by 1 plus I raised to N3 minus 1 into CR3 plus CS3. That is, K3 is equal to 1 plus I raised to N3 divided by 1 plus I raised to N3 minus 1 into FCI3 minus CS3, the replacement cost plus CS3. So if you put all the given values, you will get K3 as 3,2276.78. Then you have to calculate KO3. Since the operating cost is constant throughout the service life, you can use the formula KO3 is equal to CO3 upon I. CO3 is the operating cost, annual expenses for option number 3, which is 21,000. So KO3 will be equal to 21,000 divided by 0.15. So that will give KO3 as 1,40,000. So finally, you will get total capitalized cost for option 3 as K3 plus KO3 plus WCI3. If you put the respective values, you will get K3. The total capitalized cost for option 3, KT3, is equal to 4,57,276.78. Okay. So at the end, you have got investment option number 1, investment option number 2, investment option number 3. You have got the total capitalized cost for each of the option. And if you compare the three values, you will come to know that investment option number 3 has got the least capitalized cost, and therefore this is the best choice based on the total capitalized cost. So you can go with the option number 3 and invest money in the option number 3. Okay, so with this we have understood how capitalized cost concept is used for comparing different options within a single project. This method is used to compare multiple options that are available within a single project. Okay, so with this we conclude our discussion on the method of capitalized cost. In our next lecture, we will be discussing the method of payout period. Thank you.